गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग मैम.
ओके, व्हाट हैपेंड? यू आर नॉट हैप्पी. सम ऑफ द फेसेस आर सो ग्लूमी एंड सैड. एनी प्रॉब्लम?
नो मैम.
ओके, डिड यू गेट टाइम टू गो थ्रू द स्टोरी द हैप्पी प्रिंस? वी हैव अ लिटिल मोर टू कंप्लीट. In the last class, based on the portion that we have done, I have given you questions. How many of you wrote answers for it? Arjun? Okay, Adidev, Surya, and Mary, Nirupama, Badra. What about others? Vishnupriya also. Pratish? Okay, can I see your notes? Just lift it up, show me. Okay. Okay, Badra, Nirupama, Surya. Rifa, all right. And Mary, Adidev, Melvin. Okay. Vishnupriya. Very good. But I'm not happy with all of you because some of you have not written. Aditya and I are also. Okay. Good, good. But others have not written. So those who have not answered to those questions, please read the textbook and find the answers. Okay. After completing the chapter, I'll be giving you the answers, which is answers for the questions that is at the back of your text. All right, so these are the extra questions that I am giving based on the portions that we cover, so it will help you to get a better understanding of the story. So I need your cooperation. Okay, you have to do your part well, only then the learning process will go on smoothly. All right, is that okay? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Badra, just summarize the previous portion.
A full story we should summarize.
Not the entire story, last class portion only.
The
What did we discuss in the last class? Only that.
The happy prince asked the swallow to give the red ruby on his sword hilt to the seamstress who is very poor.
Yes.
The happy prince's feet is fastened to his pedestal and cannot move. So he is asking the swallow to give the red ruby to the seamstress. First, the swallow gives so many reasons that he cannot go to the seamstress and give. And at last, he said to the happy prince, he will give to the seamstress. And while the swallow is going, he saw the queen's maid of honor. And she is telling to his lover that...
She is telling to his lover?
That I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it. But the seamstress are Melvin, so lazy.
My dear boy, listen. Listen to what she says.
So lazy. And the swallow gave the red ruby to the seamstress. And the swallow said that I felt very warm. And the happy prince told that you felt warm because you have done a good action. And the happy prince asked the swallow to give to pluck out a sapphire from his eyes and give it to the playwright who is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater. But it is too cold to write anymore. So he can sell that sapphire to the shop and buy some firewood and thus completing his playwright.
Okay, so we find that the swallow is not ready to pluck out one of the sapphire eyes because the prince would go blind. So the first help extended by the happy prince was to the seamstress, a lady whose son was ill due to fever. And we find that the red ruby was given to the seamstress so that she can buy oranges and medicine for her son. And the second help was that the happy prince is requesting swallow to give one of the sapphire eyes to the playwright. Okay, hunger has made him faint and he is not able to complete his play due to severe cold also. So we find that the swallow is not ready to fulfill the request made by the happy prince because the prince would go blind. That's where we stopped in the last class, page number 32. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that. And he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So the prince is insisting swallow to pluck out his sapphire eye and give it to the playwright. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye and flew away to the young man's garret. What is garret? In the last class we discussed already. Garret is a? Have you written down the meaning there in the text? What is garret? Garret?
Unfinished part of a house.
Okay. Who gave me that answer? Anne-Marie? Is that you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, dear. At least one is there responding. Unfinished part of a room or as just under the roof. Unfinished part of a house just under the roof is known as garret. So swallow flew away to young man's garret. It was easy enough to get in as there was a hole in the roof. So you can imagine what a pathetic condition was the house of the playwright. And there was a hole in the roof so that swallow could easily get into it. Through this he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. So the man was too tired to look around. He did not notice what was happening around. He was lying there on the table by keeping his head inside his hands, buried in his hands. And when he woke up, he was surprised to see a precious gemstone nearby his on the withered violets near on his table. And beginning to be appreciated, he cried, this is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. So when the playwright woke up, he saw the beautiful, precious gemstone, sapphire, on his table. And he felt so happy, thinking that it was a gift from an admirer. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors working. I'm going to Egypt, cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. So we find that swallow, every day swallow was determined to go to Egypt. What was the reason why swallow was planning to go to Egypt?
Because his friends have already reached there.
Because his friends have already reached Egypt. But there is one particular reason. Why is he migrating?
Because
snow will be there summer, soon.
It is coming cold. So
yes, the climate is becoming cold. Okay, so he is migrating to have a better climate. In Egypt, the climate is warm. And that is why he plans to go to Egypt. So every day, swallow is determined to go to Egypt. But then we find that the happy prince keep on requesting, swallow, swallow, my dear little swallow, just for tonight. Just remain with me for one more day. I have come to bid you goodbye, he cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm on the green palm trees and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them. So the reason why the swallow wanted to reach Egypt is he wants to protect himself from the cold climate. In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they are all spoiled. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. And she is crying. She has no shoes or stockings, and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. So the third person to be helped by the happy prince was the little match girl. In the square below, what do you mean by square? Is it the square that we draw in mathematics or something else? Square? What is a square? Any idea?
Square. The middle of a town.
Yes, whatever is there in your mind, please let it out. Lots. Only then we can have a clarification. All of you switch on your cameras, okay? Every one of you. I don't want to call out your names particularly, but your camera should be on. Hiya. Okay, tell me what is square?
A junction. Junction.
Junction? A square is an open space. A square is an open space in a city or a town surrounded by buildings. Okay, square is an open space. An open space in a city or a town surrounded by buildings. In the square below, there stands a little match girl. Now the happy prince's eyes have fallen on a small match girl who was standing in the square. And she was crying. What is the reason why she was crying? Because she has let her matchsticks fall in the gutter. You know that the matchsticks will not work if it becomes wet. So by mistake, all the matchsticks, she used to live her life by selling the matchsticks. So everything has fallen into the water and it has got spoiled. So she is standing there and crying, thinking that she will be scolded by her father if she does not bring home money. She has no shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. So just imagine whether it is animals or birds or human beings, we have to have necessary things in order to protect us from extreme cold. So the little girl does not have shoes or stockings and she does not have a scarf also. Okay, she's standing in the center of the city with bare head and not having enough necessary clothes to protect her from the cold. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. So to whom was Princess second sapphire eye was given?
The match girl. The match girl.
To whom the second sapphire eye of the prince was given? To the little match girl. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then. So one of the eyes has already been given to the playwright. Now only one eye is remaining and the prince is asking the swallow to give that too. So the swallow refuses completely. No, no, I will not pluck out the other eye from you. If so, you would become completely blind. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. So after all, he's a prince, he commands. So the swallow did not have any other choice but to obey him. So he plucked out the other sapphire eye from the prince and he quickly flew with it and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Maybe the girl was not able to understand the worth or the price of the gemstone, but then she understood that anyway, if she sell it, she'll be able to get money. So she was so happy and she ran home with it. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You're blind now, he said, so I will stay with you always. So in these lines, we find that a beautiful friendship has started between the happy prince and the swallow. So initially, we found that swallow was eager to go to Egypt. Okay, he was only concerned about himself. Somehow he wanted to get away from the cold climate. But once he realized that the prince does not have any more sight, He thought of remaining with prince forever. So the swallow says to prince, I will stay with you always. So good friends are like that, right? They will stay with you during the tough times and in the good times. No, little swallow, said the poor prince. You must go away to Egypt. So now the prince has given away all the precious things that he had. He gave his red ruby to the woman who was a seamstress. He gave one of his sapphire eyes to the playwright and the other one was given to the little match girl. And now he will not be able to see anything else. So the prince tells Swallow, you have to go to Egypt now. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. All the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. So at this point of time, we find that the swallow refused to leave Happy Prince. What is the reason? Adidev, what is the reason why swallow refused to leave the Happy Prince?
Because.
Do not start your answer with because. I have told you already. Give me a complete sentence.
So Allah refused to go to Egypt.
Yes.
And stayed with Happy Prince because the Happy Prince is blind. He is so he helped so people and so sympathy towards him and the great friendship.
The swallow refused to leave Happy Prince because he became blind as a result of his generous deeds. Okay, Happy Prince was so good in helping others, and as a result, he lost his two eyes and he won't be able to see anything else around him. So Swallow did not want to leave Happy Prince. Okay. So all the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. So now, who is serving as the prince's eye? Nirupama? What is the role played by Swallow now? Till now, we find that Swallow was acting as a messenger. He was carrying out the request made by the prince. But now, the role of the Swallow has been shifted to something else. What is that?
He guided Happy Prince.
Yes, he guided Happy Prince. So in a way, we can say that he has become the eyes of the Happy Prince. Got it? The inner meaning. The Swallow's role has changed from a messenger to that of something great. That is, he started serving as the eyes of Happy Prince. The whole day, he remained with Happy Prince and he started describing what was around. Okay, he described the stories of what he had seen in strange lands to Happy Prince so that the Happy Prince will get an idea what is all happening around. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. So do you think that the prince is eager to know about the marvelous things from Swallow and Mary? Do you think that he is eager to know about the marvelous and beautiful things around?
Yes, but he is saying that more than that, it is the suffering of the people living in his city.
Yes, very good. So we find that the prince is more concerned about the people, about the suffering of the men and women. He was not so interested to hear or listen to the marvelous things around, but then he wanted to know about the sufferings of men and women. So in the initial part of the story, we find that the tears were running down the prince's eyes because he could not bear with the sufferings of the poor ones. So he wants Swallow to explain about the miserable conditions of the poor people around him. And that is why he says, more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. There is no mystery so great as misery. When we look around, we can easily see that the rich people enjoy their life to the fullest. Okay? Dancing, drinking, merrymaking and all so on. But is it possible to see that how poor ones lead their life? Vishnupriya, what do you think?
No, ma'am.
Is it possible to really understand how the poor ones lead their life?
No.
No, it is difficult. Only if you go deep into it, only if we are about to go and identify what is the real problem, we will be able to understand. So here in the story, we find that the Happy Prince looked into the difficulties of each and every one. That is why about the seamstress he is describing in detail. Her hands have become coarse, rough, red in color because it has been pricked by the needles very often. And she's too tired. And that is why she is lying on the table. It's not because she's taking rest or it's not because she's lazy. She's so tired to work. She has been working from morning till evening, and that is why she has become so tired. So only if you look into the problems of the people into the deeper level, we'll be able to understand. Okay, I still remember a beautiful video that came into WhatsApp a few months before. That is, a school situation is shown. A classroom is shown. I do not know whether you have seen the video or not. But anyway, it's a beautiful video. It really touched my heart. Okay, a classroom is shown and it's the lunch time, lunch break. The bell is out and the children were ready to have their lunch. So everyone sat on their chair and they opened their lunch boxes and they were having their food. But then we find that only one boy, he quickly sat on the chair, he opened his lunch box, and then the very next moment he closed it. Have you seen this video? Yes. Any one of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. John also. Okay, not everyone, right? So anyway, let me complete it. So this particular boy opened his lunch box and he quickly closed it. And then he went to the pipe and he's washing his hands. And then when he came back to his seat, he was surprised to see that his lunch box was a bit heavy. Okay? So everyone was under the impression that the boy had his lunch so fast so that he opened it and very soon he closed it and he went to wash his hand. But in the next scene, we find that the boy, when the boy came to keep his box, lunch box inside his bag, he found it was a bit heavy. To his surprise, the box was a bit heavy. And when he opened, he saw a lot of food items in it. What could have happened there? What was the reality? Can anyone tell me?
Children. So
did the boy really have the lunch?
No.
Children gave.
The lunch box was empty. The lunch box was completely empty. He did not have anything to eat. He was pretending that he had his food fast. Okay. He opened it and he closed it quickly. But then one of the students from the class realized that he did not have any food, and by the time he went to wash his hands, they all contributed little by little and his lunch box was full. Are you able to follow me?
Yes.
That's what you mean by sharing. Sharing is always caring. So we find that if we have to understand the real situation of people, we have to look into it. We have to go deep into it. It's not easy to understand the miseries of the people around us. We may think that all the people are leading a fantastic life, but it's not the fact. There will be many people in and around us who are going through tough times. So we find that Happy Prince, once his statue was kept above, high above the city, he could see all the miseries, and that is why the tears were running out of his eyes. So he says that there is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. So Happy Prince was not at all interested to listen to the marvelous and beautiful things around him, but he's requesting Swallow to tell him about the miseries of the people around him. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. So look at the different living styles of the people. Rich people were making merry. They were enjoying to the fullest in the beautiful houses. They had marvelous houses. But on the other hand, Swallow saw something strange. Beggars were sitting at the gates. They were begging for a bit of bread or for a piece of bread. He flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. So the small children were starving. We can't even afford to wait for some time without having food. Can we? The moment we feel hungry, we would call out our mom. Mom, isn't the food ready? Breakfast is ready. I'm feeling hungry. Am I right? Yes. we are not able to bear the hunger. But there are people around us who are really poor, who cannot even afford a single piece of bread, at least once in a day time. He flew into the dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. So the climate is very cold there, and they did not have any sweaters or blankets to protect them from the cold climate. So what were the children doing? Hey, Steve, how did the children try to make themselves warm? Hey, Steve, are you there? No response. Maybe he's having a connectivity problem. Meghna, tell me, how did the children try to make themselves warm in the cold climate?
They were lying in each other's arms and protect from...
Yes, they were lying in each other's arms. They held each other closely, thinking that they'll get some warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. So the children were so hungry, and they were feeling so cold also. But then, very unfortunately, we find that the watchman is shouting at them to leave that place. So these are all the things that the swallow see when he flew around the city. Okay, so pathetic conditions are viewed by the swallow. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I'm covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off, leaf by leaf, and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. Do you all agree that gold will make us happy? Yes, especially the questions to girls. Girls, are you fond of gold jewelries? Huh? Small gold chains or beautiful earrings and all? Girls, I'm asking you. Yes, no, sir, no. No. Now you're not fond of. But I think maybe once you grow big, you'll be fond of, definitely. Anyway, now we cannot think about buying gold because the price of gold is going too high, right? But still, people always becomes happy when they get something as a gift in the form of gold. So the prince tells the swallow, you must take it off leaf by leaf. So what is remaining with the prince now? John, we find that the prince has given away all the precious things from his body. He has given red ruby to the seamstress. One of the sapphire eyes was given to the playwright. And the second one was given to the little match girl. And what else is remaining with him? John? John, no response. Connectivity problem. John, can you hear me? Okay, then question is passed to Prajodh. Yeah, tell me. What else is remaining with the prince?
He was covered with gold.
Yes, his body was covered with gold. So now the prince is asking the swallow to take it off leaf by leaf. Little by little, he can take it and give to the poor and needy ones. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and gray. So until the statue became dull and gray, the swallow took off the gold leaf by leaf and gave it to the people. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor. And the children's faces grew rosier, and they laughed and played in the street. We have bread now, they cried. So what does this word bread suggest here? Does it have the only meaning a loaf of bread, which we have it for breakfast or as a snack in the evening? Or does it have a more meaning? Bread. Arjun, the children felt so happy when they got piece of gold, and they tells that we have bread now. What do you mean by bread here, Arjun?
When they sell that gold, they can eat how much bread?
No, I'm just asking you, what does bread indicates? Bread stands for what?
Bread indicates food.
Louder?
Bread indicates one food
to eat. Louder, it's not clear for me.
Food to eat.
Yes, food. Yes, basically food. We have bread now, which means that the children are so happy that they have got something to eat. They have food now. They were starving till then. But once they got a fine piece of gold, they were so happy and they declared that they have got food now. They cried. Okay, so I think I'll stop by here. It's time for us to wind up. So is the portion clear to you, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. So I want all of you to read the text thoroughly, okay? It's not enough that you know the summary of the story, but you have to have a clear understanding of each and every line. Only then you will be able to answer to the questions, okay? Extra questions as well as short answer questions will be coming from all the chapters. So read the text as many times as possible, and I'll be sending you the questions, short answer questions and extra questions based on the portion that we have covered today through WhatsApp. And everyone should write it. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, please respond. Unmute and respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear or not?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I'll meet you in the next class. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.